So, ladies and gentlemen, we're finally here.
Avenger!
That intro just sucked, bruh.
I'm here to tell you right now, we don't care.
Let me tell you.
We don't care.
All right, so in this series, I cover all types of weird and funny examples of propaganda in media and in social media and how it affects our daily lives and how exactly we can spot it. And also, if you want to see more examples of propaganda in media, you guys can check out the other parts of the series, which will be linked in the iCard and also in the description. And also, disclaimer, please do not target or harass any people mentioned in this video because this is all just meant for good fun and educational purposes, so please don't do that. And also, before we get straight into it, I just want you to like and subscribe because it really does help the channel and the algorithm. Thank you very much for all your support, and let's just get straight into it. All right, so let me first talk about John Wick 4. This is one of the main things that actually inspired this video.
Kiss me through the phone.
He copied my whole fucking flow.
Oh,
word for
shit.
Word, bar for bar.
Now, here's the thing, right? Is that the second highest casted role in this movie, besides Keanu Reeves playing John Wick, was from Donnie Yen, who gave a performance as a blind assassin. Now, you might be wondering, what exactly is the issue with Donnie Yen? Well, as it turns out, he's a card-holding member of the Chinese Communist Party. In other words, he is a direct supporter and contributor to the Chinese government, which this government is not really one of the cleanest governments in the world. Keep that in mind. Now, here's the problem with this, right? Not only is he a card-holding member, he's literally part of the fucking government. Like, he is part of a body, and this body, it is called the CCPPC. And this body is supposed to be the quote-unquote representative body in the Chinese government, which is a load of BS, because democracy does not exist in China, so there can't really be actually accurate representation.
You serious?
But anyway, basically, he was actually appointed onto this council as a representative of arts and cinema. And not only that, but he also hosted part of the Oscars this year, which there was a petition to actually try to prevent him from hosting his little section of the Oscars, but it was ultimately unsuccessful, unfortunately. So you might be wondering, why exactly is this important? I think it's pretty fucking obvious why it's important. It's a literal government member of the CCP. He's a representative for the Chinese government to, in a way, make them look good. And let me explain why. Because he is a representative for arts and culture and movies, or whatever the fuck his title is, he basically has to make China and more or less the Chinese government look good.
Give it to me! Give it to me! Give it to me! Give it to me! Just give it!
And that is a bad thing because that is whitewashing all the terrible actions they've done. And since he is a film representative, he can paint Chinese culture, or more broadly, the Chinese government in a good way, which is ultimately a bad thing, considering all of the very, very bad things the government has done. So that is why Donnie Yen, being probably one of the most important roles in John Wick 4, was a very bad thing. Which is honestly such a shame, because Donnie Yen's choreography is actually really good in this movie. So honestly, it really sucks that he's a dick writer for a genocidal regime. Oh god, this video is already 4 minutes long and I've only talked about one topic. Okay, time to move on to the next. Alright guys, so now this is one of my favorite tweets of all time. Hear me out. Oh god, no good tweets just to hear me out. China and Russia are technically our biggest rivals. So why don't we team up with them? Oh my god, guys, he's really onto something, guys. But don't worry, guys, the genius doesn't end there. China gets control of Asia, Russia gets control of Europe, USA gets control of North, Central, and South America. Then we all win.
Oh my god!
This is such an awesome tweet. This is just fucking epic. This is so fucking dumb. What the fuck is that? All right, let's see what we should talk about. Elon Musk. All right, so Elon Musk has been doing a lot of stupid shit over the last year, and I don't really have to review all that because you probably already know a few examples of his tomfoolery. But however, one of the most really stupid ones that I just really hate is how Elon Musk claims that he does not really care what other people think about him, and he doesn't really care about what he says, even if it has impact on his businesses. So, for example, whenever he says controversial opinions on Twitter or X or whatever the fuck he wants to call it, the stock prices in the company that he owns actually dips because of the controversial shit he's saying. And this would kind of seem to prove that he doesn't really care what people think or say about him, right? Well, no, not really. Because the thing is that Elon, he does actually care about the money, but it's not as obvious as it may seem. You see, Elon Musk has actually been playing second fiddle to the Chinese government. Well, how exactly is that possible? Well, because Tesla has one of its biggest manufacturing centers in China, mainland China more specifically, and this is a giant economic factor in Tesla's production, and this is a huge factory. And because there's so much output from this factory and also from the domestic Chinese market for Tesla cars, he is very careful not to offend the Chinese market or the Chinese government in any way. Because the difference between China and America is that the Chinese government can get very offended very easily, and they can have a harsh punishment for you if you do something they don't like. So that's why Elon Musk has never really criticized China publicly, or well, at the very least, very recently. But it doesn't end there. You see, Elon Musk is actually allowing for more propaganda to be on Twitter.
Ew!
Dude!
What the fuck?
And China is using that to their advantage. For example, propaganda mouthpieces from the government, like these I'm showing on the screen, and also even more, have been allowed to propagate on Twitter, even though some of them have actually previously been banned. It's only that, but Twitter has actually removed the state-affiliated label on a lot of these accounts. You see, if a news organization or a person tweeting is related to the government or is funded by the government in some way, Twitter would disclose that on their accounts by saying that they were being funded by a specific country or regime.
What? No, dude!
So, for example, previously, a lot of news organizations that belong to certain countries' governments actually had this distinction on their account. However, after Elon Musk took over, they're now actually gone, and they just look like normal accounts now. And not only that, they're also verified. And actually, adding these state media labels actually diminished the influence of these accounts. However, now that they're back, they can have as much influence as they want. And all this is very much deliberate and was done on purpose. There's no way all this was an accident. And if you still don't believe that Elon Musk takes advantage of the CCP for his own economic interests,
what the hell?
Well, I have one last piece of evidence for you. And that's that Elon Musk one time tweeted questioning the origins of COVID, and it was very critical of the Chinese government, obviously. And this got the Chinese government pretty angry, and they actually warned him about the tweet. And they actually had their state news media papers calling him out for this tweet. And subsequently afterwards, he stopped being critical of China and in fact started making tweets that were positive of China, which was way after. But still, this definitely proves something at the very least. And this is the smoking gun to me that indicates that Elon Musk is praising China only for his economic interest, and also that he's a hypocrite because of all the shit he said earlier, because that's simply just not true. Alright, well, that was a long-ass rant. Anyway, time to get this video more views by talking about a topical topic. Well, at the time of recording this, at least. and that's Barbie. So everyone knows about the Barbie movie by this point. It's one of the highest grossing movies of this year, and I personally haven't watched it yet. However, from what I've heard, it looks really good. Now, that's not the main point. Now, the thing about this movie is that this movie does not necessarily have propaganda. However, there was a news story about its release that kind of involves weird amounts of propaganda, and it's kind of strange. Let me explain, because it's nothing like I've ever seen before. You see, in the trailer of the movie, some people noted how there was this world map, and right next to this world map, there seemed to be this dashed line which was near Asia, more specifically China. And this was misinterpreted by some people as being the Nine Dash Line. If you don't know what the Nine Dash Line is, it's a territorial claim made by China, which basically says that they own the entirety of the South China Sea, which is obviously south of China.
Hey, 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 nigga, you got a nice little ass, nigga. Give me your ass, nigga. Nigga, you see me looking at you, nigga. Give me your ass, nigga.
And, of course, this makes a lot of people mad because, obviously, they don't really have the full right to control all this territory. And also because many other countries in the area have overlapping claims with China and each other. Which is why a lot of people got offended when they thought that the Barbie movie had the Nine Dash Line. Now, the actual situation was that the Nine Dash Line was not actually in the movie. This was just happened to be a bunch of dashes that happened to look like the Nine Dash Line on the map. And if you look on the map, it doesn't even really look like the Nine Dash Line. This looks like a map that a child drew, which I'm assuming that's kind of the point of this map. And you can see that there's dashes and random marks everywhere on this map, and it's not even accurate to the actual world map. However, despite this, the movie actually got banned in Vietnam because of this, and it was actually fine to release beforehand. However, because of this map error that was noticed, they actually subsequently banned the movie because Vietnam has a lot of disputes with China regarding the South China Sea, and they typically ban movies that show a nine dash line in them. Now, obviously, none of this was actually intentional.
No, he orchestrated it. Jimmy!
And Warner Bros. Actually issued a statement saying that this was not meant to be a geopolitical statement of any kind, and that this was just a prop in the movie, just showing a map, and it just happened to have a dash, which looked like the nine dash line. So, I think we can just say, by far, this is probably one of the weirdest controversies slash examples of propaganda movie, because it wasn't even intentional. However, it got noticed, and people thought it was propaganda. Not only that, but a senator from Texas, Ted Cruz, actually called the Barbie movie out as having Chinese communist propaganda, even though that was not the intention at all.
We shall never surrender!
Alright, so we talked a lot about how movies include propaganda, but in this video I haven't really talked about censorship. Here's the thing, is that a lot of movies censor themselves to get accepted into different countries because countries have different social norms and things will have to be adapted. Now, this is not really necessarily censorship. However, it's censorship when the government or an organization changes something on purpose from the original story and essentially changes the whole meaning of it. And the only reason for doing this is trying to cover up some sensitive topic or something that the audience may not like. And this is the exact thing which happened with the Minions and the Fight Club movie. So, Minions the Rise of Gru was a massive meme last year, and if you watch the movie ends with a spoiler alert. It ends with a villain, Wild Knuckles, and Gru getting away after they successfully faked their death, and they got away, presumably doing a bunch of crimes and shit. However, in the Chinese release, at the end of the movie, there was actually an added text at the end of the movie saying that Wild Knuckles actually got imprisoned for 20 years after he was caught by the cops, and also that Gru later returned to his family, and that his greatest accomplishment in life was being the father of three daughters. Alright, so I don't need to tell you that this is really stupid. However, where it gets even more stupid is with the censoring of the 1999 cult classic film Fight Club's ending. If you know the ending of Fight Club, basically there's a successful plot to destroy a series of buildings, and it's successfully executed, right? However, in the Chinese version of the movie, it actually cuts to a black screen with a note to viewers saying that the police, quote, rapidly figured out the whole plan and arrested all criminals, successfully preventing the bomb from exploding. And it says for Brad Pitt's character in the movie that he was sent to an asylum and was later discharged. Now here's the thing, is that the censored ending to this movie was extremely obvious to both foreigners and also Chinese viewers alike, and it was also criticized heavily from many different groups, from social media in China, to social media in the US, to even the Human Rights Watch. Even the writer of the original novel which inspired the film actually said, quote, "This is super wonderful. Everyone gets a happy ending in China." Now, honestly, I don't need a genius to tell you that he was being sarcastic there. However, the good news about this in the end is that about a few weeks later, after there was all the outrage about how the movie was censored, the ending actually got reverted back to the original ending, where they successfully do the plan to blow up all the buildings. The worrying part about this is that this only came after there was so much outcry and controversy and call out from all these different organizations and influential people. So while, yes, there can be change, it will take a lot for something even as minor as a movie ending to change. All right, now let's move on to something that is not really as funny, but is more depressing than anything else. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. So I want to talk about the 2019 Hong Kong protests and more specifically, Blizzard's response to the whole thing. You see, during the whole protest event, Blizzard was holding a Hearthstone tournament in Taiwan, and one of their professional esports players named Blitzchung from Hong Kong was seen wearing a mask during a live stream, which was very similar to the ones that were worn by the Hong Kong protesters. And after a match, he uttered the phrase, "Liberate Hong Kong, Revolution of Our Times," which is actually a very popular political slogan used by anti-Chinese supporters. After this phrase was uttered, the stream was actually cut off, and then the next day, Blizzard announced that Blitzchung had been banned and all the money that he won would be forfeit. And this move was very heavily criticized by many, many people. You see, Blizzard claimed that Blitzchung had actually violated Blizzard's policy on avoiding politics during matches. However, many people call him out, as many people interpreted this move as trying to hush up to the Chinese government and in a way basically supporting what the Chinese government was doing in Hong Kong. You see, so many people are mad that there was actually a worldwide boycott of Blizzard on Twitter called #BoycottBlizzard, and there was a walkout at the company of Blizzard. Not only that, but the United States Congress came together. Senators and representatives from both houses and both parties decided to speak against the ban, and they sent a letter to the offices of Blizzard, a signed letter, in fact, to the offices of Blizzard, and they asked that the ban actually be repealed, and they stressed the importance of human rights and basic freedoms. So the aftermath of this was around a month later, Blizzard essentially apologized by saying that they didn't live up to their high standards and that they basically failed themselves in their purpose, and they essentially just took accountability for their own actions. Meanwhile, Epic Games decided to take a jab at what Blizzard had done, and this is pretty ironic considering they're 40% owned by a Chinese company, Tencent. Their statement on the matter was that Epic Games supports everyone's right to express their views on politics and human rights. We wouldn't ban or punish a Fortnite player or content creator for speaking on these topics.
Guys! Mods ban that guy and blow up his fucking house!
Meanwhile, Riot Games, the creators of League of Legends, actually stayed silent on the whole affair. They are 100% owned by Tencent, the Chinese company, and they were also accused of banning certain words in-game, such as even Hong Kong. But in the end, this was a whole massive blunder for Blizzard, and I hope they've definitely learned their lesson, because it seems that if you try to silence people who speak their opinion, there'll be a massive backlash out against it, especially if you're doing it for the purpose of pleasing an autocratic regime.
Nigga, shut the hell up and eat a cinnamon roll.
This Disney DVD is enhanced with
Genocide Fast Play. This movie is really bad. And not only that, it isn't like Hong Kong. Not only that, but it also supports a genocide and a dictator. Okay, let's begin this section of the video.
Excuse me, what the actual fuck?
Alright, with that weird ass intro out of the way, let me talk about probably one of the worst examples of propaganda in movies of this decade, I'll say. And that, without a doubt, has to be Mulan 2020. This corporate pile piece of shit is actually just so bad. Now, this movie is bad within itself. The editing, the screenwriting, the character development, and how it's an insult to the original Mulan movie from 1998. All of that is in mind, but that's not the important thing here. The important thing is the propaganda elements. Now, this movie has in its cast Donnie Yen, which I've already talked about enough about that little fucker. Also, the main actress who plays Mulan actually supported the Hong Kong police during when they were doing their crackdown at the Hong Kong protesters. So that's not a good sign already. Alright, but the main controversy around the film was actually where it was actually filmed. It was filmed in a northwestern region of China called Xinjiang, and this region was very controversial because currently in this region, there is an ethnic cultural genocide going on of the native Uyghur people who traditionally have lived here. And this genocide is being carried out by the government, and it is 100% sponsored by the government. And the government has been doing anything to deny their involvement or that this is even happening in the first place. The reason this whole controversy came about was because in the credits of the movie, they actually gave credit to some of the Xinjiang authorities. And these same authority organizations are the ones who are carrying out the genocide against the native Uyghurs. And in fact, a lot of these organizations are actually sanctioned by the US now. It was so bad, in fact, that members of the British government, members of the US Congress, and members of many human rights organizations around the world massively condemned the movie Mulan for all of its support for human rights abuses. So overall, a fuck you to Disney and for whoever allowed this to happen, because you should not be supporting and filming in a region where there is slave labor and also a cultural genocide. And for one, you should not be supporting the organizations who are allowing this to happen. Next, I want to talk about this video I saw on Instagram. Now, this video is mostly harmless. However, it is very problematic. And this also includes the comments section of the video as well. You see, this video is an instance of cherry picking. They've only shown good parts of China, and they portrayed that this is what China always looks like, when we know, well, that's not really true, is it now? Okay, but is this video itself actually propaganda? Well, I'll let you decide that. And also, this video just screams in title. The main problem with the video comes with the response and also the counter response to this video. You see, the comment section on Instagram instantly called this person out for basically glorifying China and just being very biased, obviously. But then there's an interesting phenomenon happened. You see, the comments got flooded with Chinese nationalists and also pro-Chinese sentiments. And these comments actually became the most liked comments on the post, and they became the most common sentiment on this video. Alright, so let's go over the comments and see if we can spot any propaganda tactics. Alright, so we got this comment. It says, hate from Taiwan, which honestly, W comment. Now first, we got this reply, which was originally in Chinese, and it translates saying, you shut up! The hell! Who wants you to like it? You'll die if you don't say a word. What the fuck are you saying?
Every day I wake up and I hope you're dead!
I just like to assume the bad grammar didn't come with the translation, but he just legitimately does not know the concept of grammar at all in any language. Why do you hate your hometown? China is mom of Taiwan. Please respect your motherland. Oh wow, great work, paid Instagram user on that one, and good job getting 23 likes. Who the actual fuck liked this, by the way?
The level of ignorant anti-Chinese sentiment in his comments is truly bonker.
Who actually uses the term bonkers unironically? Dude, get a grip.
On some real Animal Farm level of two legs bad, four legs good.
I don't think this guy has actually read Animal Farm, because if you read the book, you'll know that that book is, you know, it's anti-communist. The guy who wrote Animal Farm is anti-communist. It's fucking George Orwell. Are you dumb? Man, that last line is really just fucking irony. Like, at this point, it's just projection. We don't beat up Muslims. No one was saying that. That's only you, pal. And because you said that, that just makes me think that you personally like to beat up Muslims, and that's just messed up, dude. And also, that's also just a great way to start the comment, too. The most ironic part about this whole video is how this video was shot in mainland China, and there's tons of comments in here from mainland China defending mainland China. But guess what? Instagram is actually blocked in mainland China. So what did they use to bypass mainland China censors? That's right, they use a VPN, which is illegal in China, and can actually get you jail time. So people are defending the government of China, and in return, they're going to get imprisoned for doing so. So that right there is 500 IQ intellect. Good job, CCP meat writers. Good job.
Come in with the Tiffany's and take a shot of Hennessy. I know I'm not there mentally, but you could be the remedy. So let me play my violin for you.
So if you made it this far, I really want to congratulate you, because I guarantee that not many people have made it here. So what have we learned exactly? Well, we've learned that propaganda can come in all shapes and forms, obviously, and that the best propaganda works discreetly. In other words, propaganda works when we don't notice it's actually propaganda. This is why it's really important to be vigilant and pay attention to certain things that certain people are trying to say. And this is also why common sense and also critical thinking are really important in today's world, because there's so much information on the internet, so you have to be really careful about the sources you get, and also you have to sometimes use your brain if you think something just doesn't seem right. And also, in other words, it's really important to get out of our comfort zone and sometimes question the biases that we have. There's so many other things I want to talk about in this video, such as TikTok being really dumb in terms of propaganda, and also how propagandists that I covered on previous parts of this series have actually responded to the allegations. Not to my allegations specifically, but to other allegations more generally. And I really didn't want to talk about these, but there just was not enough time, and you can judge that by the timestamp. But I've just been yappering on for way too long, so let's just get on to the outro already, guys. If you guys liked this video, remember to like, comment, and subscribe, because it really does help out the channel. And that's all I have to say. So thank you for watching. See ya. Peace. Goodbye.
We? Now we going to
what
war.
Do you mean we? Nintendo?
No,
we?
Nigga. We as in us.
Us? Are you talking about
no,
the
nigga. Us.